Wonderful. All right. So now, my first job out of college, I was working for Honeywell. How many people remember the movie The Hunt for Red October? Remember that? If you don't know the movie, here it is. Russian submarine, American submarine, shooting torpedoes at each other, right? I worked on the Mach 50 system, the torpedo system in that movie, right? And so here's how the torpedo works. It's very fascinating. They can launch it from a ship or drop it from a helicopter. And as soon as it hits the water, it turns on. It begins to make a circular pattern. And the sonar system begins to turn on. You know that? Boom! That boom! Here, you try. Oh, that's pretty good. One more time. Let's let it go. Okay? So what happens is the sonar system turns on. Here's what happens. What it does, it emits a sound, and it'll bounce off an object in the distance, and it'll return that profile, that signature. And what is it looking for? It's looking for the outline of a submarine. Everybody with me? So now it's looking for the outline of a submarine. So the torpedo's dropped in the water, begins to make a circular pattern, ping, ping, and then it says, oh, I think I found it. And then it moves off in that direction, goes ping, more resolution, ping, more resolution, ping, more resolution. Says, ah, underwater rock formation, not what I'm looking for, breaks off the attack. Goes back into a circular pattern, begins to ping again, the same thing. And I said, ah, I think I found it. Goes ping, gets closer, ping, gets closer. Ah, school of fish, not what I'm looking for. Get the idea? And it goes after maybe a whale. You don't want to hit a whale with a torpedo. Overkill, right? But here's what's fascinating. Here's what's fascinating. As a torpedo goes after something, and it isn't what it wants, does it just stop? It just keeps what? Right, it has something called artificial intelligence. And here's the fascinating part, that when it goes after something and it's not what it wants, it learns from that iteration. It updates its programming, its algorithm. Now think about this, this is very powerful, because everybody in here is a torpedo. You ever try something for the first time, you get all excited, yeah, I'm gonna do this, right? And then you go after it, and when it isn't what you want, what do you think most people do? They say, I'm going home. Can you imagine a torpedo saying, I quit after the first shot, right? It won't do that, right? Most people will just go after something and stop. See, learning sales, learning to sell plexus is a process. Much like the torpedo, you're gonna try a certain approach, and most likely it's not gonna work. But what do? The winners learn from that. You update your programming. That's part of the process of learning. And then you go off in another direction, you try to figure it out. What happens eventually is a torpedo finds its what? Object every single time. And that's who we are. That's what you need to tell people when they get frustrated, when they can't sell the product. You're a torpedo. You got to keep updating the program. And after a while, you get very good at it. And some of you in here, probably many of you, are very good at it because you've gone, believe it or not, through the process of learning. But here's what happens. Listen to this data. 78% of the population is either unhappy or would rather be doing something else. Listen to that number. 78% of the population is either unhappy or would rather be doing something else. I submit to you what happened is that they went after something, and when it didn't work out, they quit. That was one. Or they went after something, and then they stayed there hoping things would change. And as we know, hope is not a strategy. We can't hope things will change. You ever go out to take a job? Don't raise your hand. You ever take a job and you say, I'm gonna just do this for a year? What happens? You start rationalizing, right? A year passes by, you're still doing it. What are you telling your brain? Well, I'll just stay here for another year. Well, I'll just stay here for the health insurance. I'll just stay here and maybe things will change. I'll just stay here and maybe management will get hit by a bus and things will change. You know what I mean? But we rationalize these things, right? You ever take the word rationalize apart? It's the ability to what? Rationalize to ourselves, because that's what we do. We talk ourselves into something. But again, much like the torpedo, go after something, update your programming, that's the process of selling. Because sometimes we're very afraid to try new things. And in our business, do we have to try new things all the time? When you gotta promote your product, when you gotta get out there and grab people's attention, you have to think creatively. You have to think out of the box, which means you have to try new things. And in today's market, consumers are smarter. Think about this, consumers have more access to information than they've ever had. 10, 15 years ago, internet really didn't exist to the extent it does today. Today, customers can go online and research you. See, it isn't about the product. It isn't about the price. It's never about the price. It's always about you. In today's market, and I'm not saying this to make you feel better, it is fact. In today's market, you, the one-on-one, belly-to-belly salesperson, relationship person, you are the differentiator in this market. You really are. And it all comes down to telling the right story. And we're going to talk about that on Saturday. But we have to try new things.